My name's Gerry Bassermann. I'm with Sequential. This is the Prophet X. To be a prophet, you have to have a lot of analog, juicy goodness. But in this case, we added another ingredient, which is the samples. So this is a company called 8DO as our partner up there, 8DO from California. And they are specialists in what we call deep sampling. Deep sampling means every nuance of every sound, every mic placement, many layers of dynamics. If you go through the sound set, 150 gigabytes worth of sounds that are in there, you'll see that there are so many different variations of every piece. All the instruments playing all the idioms of their instruments, strings, winds, all orchestral instruments, pianos, clavinets, organs, electric pianos, ethnic sounds, complete strange dystopian landscapes, abstract, loopy, weird, bad, cool stuff. Drums, radical, harsh, aggressive sounds, soft, caressing choirs, little boys' voices, you know, echoing in the wilderness. This is what you have in there. Plus the oscillators, all that going through the analog filters and VCAs and the rest of it makes for an amazing combination of sound. And that's what the Prophet X is. It's basically right here mixing together the two channels of samples and the two oscillators and getting them to interact in the modulation section, getting the samples to be able to frequency modulate the filter or the oscillators, getting them to really influence each other. That's what it's all about.
That not only sounds awesome, I think that sounds awesome also.
Yeah, that sounds awesome, yeah. Octaves of sound. You turn this off and turn the instrument up and choose piano and you'd have a beautiful grand. Can really take sounds that are normal and beautiful and strings and clarinets and whatever and really bend them and really make them into what you want. You can also use your own samples. In December, we're going to come out with software that allows you to take your recordings and convert them to this format and then be able to put them in here, the sample input, and they will come up in the same, you know, a different bank. Alongside the ADO samples.
So, wow, that sounds really great.
A lot of possibilities.
Yeah. Is it a multi-sampling? Is a multi-sampling involved?
Yes, absolutely. Well, now we have a really wacky sound, of course. Turns sample stretch off. You have multi-sample and you have many layers of velocity switching. So that's not the filter, that's the
yeah, I can hear that, switches. Yes. Yeah.
And then so you have many of these mic positions as well, near, short, far, front, back, all the different mic positions that they recorded the piano with. Now they recorded, look, with pedal on, now the somebody samples with the pedal down. So that's what they do.
Is it based on impulse response somehow?
No, it's literally the recording. It's just that they do a lot of it. You know, not
all
only
right.
dynamic levels, but mic positions and all kinds of things. And then special effects, too. I mean, I think, I don't know if in the piano it's so much, but if you go to some of these other banks, like the strings, you got your pizzicato, you got a lot of your special. And then if you go down to your bass sounds, you can get your kind of acoustic basses with a lot of really nice... Just a nice growling, big, low bass sound, and then you start to mess with these things.
Well, it can be a lot of things. Obviously, it's perfectly suited as a stage piano, but that doesn't it justice enough, I think, because the sound banding you showed us is quite a feat for new explorations and actually new kind of band music.
You have like your cinematic sounds where. You have a different sound on every key, so then you can explore, like, you can use the sequencer and you can go. It's got drum kits on board, it's amazing, yeah.
And the filter, is it solely low pass or are there other characteristics?
Well, there's a four-pole low pass here that is analog, and then up here in the effects you have a high pass filter. So you have the two you can use together.
Yeah. And effects are similar to those of the other modules you just released?
I would say like Rev 2 dual effects would be very similar. I think there's more reverbs here. Three delays, five reverbs, flanger, phaser, chorus, all that stuff, rotating speaker, distortion. Yeah, a lot of effects.
And last question, maybe the timbrality of it. How many voices can you play at once?
So normally, everything 8DO does is stereo, and that's why we kept the whole path of the machine stereo. So these low pass filter, there's one for left, one for right, right? So that's eight voices when in that mode. But you can hit this button, 16 voice, instantly you collapse into mono mode and you have extra eight voices. So then you have more polyphony at that point.
Well, you get the option to choose, actually. Yeah. Sounds perfectly.
So it's $4,000 US a map, and it's coming out the first week of June, we're shipping. And then in December, we'll do the user sampling option.
Wait. Can't wait to see that.
Yeah.
Actually, yes.
Right on.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Take care.
Nice.
See ya.
See ya.